cables. They get tangled, they get mixed up, and sometimes they get lost. So in this video, I'm going to show you how you can avoid entanglement and how you can organize cables. Hi, I'm Kevin, and I'm the video producer and equipment specialist at Checkroom. Today, I'm going to cover some tips and tricks we learned from our customers in the AV industry. So if you like this video, feel free to subscribe to this video. Not to this video, to this channel. Lol, I'm almost sounding like a real YouTuber, but okay, subscribe please. I'll wait. All right, let's get started. Cables, you hate them or love them, but you know you need them. Sometimes they give you a hard time when they get all tangled or when you're working on a large project and they get mixed up with other cables from other companies. For me, there are three main things I want to see right away to keep a clear overview. First, what's the connector or type of the cable? Second, what's the cable length? And third, is this cable property of my company? If you're using the cables a lot, you can easily identify the cable by looking at the connector. But if you have a bunch of cables and you want to know how long the cable is, that's a different story. The most common way to identify the cable length is by labeling the same length cables with the same color. For example, 10 feet cables are labeled as yellow, 20 feet are green, and 35 are orange. You have several ways you can label your cables. I've seen people using color tape, that's okay-ish. It won't last for many years though, and it will get sticky. But it's quite cheap. Another method that I've seen is tag your label with spray paint. That's something I won't recommend. It's not durable and in the end it will come off like we see in this picture. The last do-it-yourself method is using colored zip ties. Something like this. These ones are of course not colored because we don't have any colored zip ties, but I think it's a valid option. It's quite sturdy, it doesn't leave glue on the cable, but if you want to replace them, you need to be really careful, because you'll get very close with your knife and you don't want to damage the cable. And bear in mind, the edge of the zip tie can be very sharp at the end. My preferred way of tagging cables is using plastic or rubber rings that are colored. It's easy to apply and safe for your cables. You can find them in different colors, but not all rings are compatible with all types of cables. Besides that, you also have colored straps. That's a win-win because you have a colored label and a strap to tie the cable together. One step higher up the ladder are dedicated plastic labels like these. You have several vendors that provide these labels and they are customizable to your needs. You can add your logo with the color with the barcode, or logo, color and the barcode. Not trying to complicate things, just saying, you have options. But indeed, barcodes. Good to mention here, because they're great if you want to track your cables. If you're using equipment management software, like for example, Checkroom, just scan the cable label and see all the details about this cable straight away. And you can bundle it with other equipment, so you know it all belongs together in one specific equipment kit. So yay for cable labels. But don't forget to add a color legend to your equipment rack. This way the newbies can identify the cables they need. Okay, we're nearly there. What about transportation? If you need to transport cables in bulk, I strongly recommend using a flight case with different sections. You should mark each section with a color relating to the cable length and add the type of cable as well. That way it's crystal clear which cable you need. If you have very long cables, you can buy the cables on the cable reel. If you already have the cables, then you can buy the cable reel separately. Easy to unroll and roll back up if you're finished. That saves you a lot of time. Guys, that was it. If you liked this video, feel free to subscribe or give us a like. And if you want to know more about equipment hacks, feel free to check out these videos. Don't leave me hanging. See you next time. Which cable do I need to take? Yep. Okay, get back into the Zoom. For me, there are three main things. Lol, not going to do that.